you guys are a bit of a sassy bunch, so I'm not quite sure how this is going to go. But first and foremost, none of you knew each other before, right? Second, you're all in a creative space. Can you we'll go down the line, if you can kind of share with the audience, like, what your business is about.
So my name is Sarah Williams, and I have a monogram subscription box.
I'm Casey Hope, and I help women relieve stress and anxiety through hand lettering.
I'm Tamara Bennett, and I help women become happy and confident through learning to paint door hangers.
I'm Christy Hawkins, and I help women find joy and encouragement through painting in my community.
And Heidi,
Heidi Easley, and I teach women how to make money teaching paint parties.
Okay, so they're all in a very creative, artsy space, which in some worlds you could think, okay, I don't want to, you know, engage with other creators because I don't want to compete. I don't want people stealing my ideas. Yada, yada. There's a lot of stories that can be told. But you guys have done something beautiful in the Connect community, and you've become this incredible group of friends. And it's, by the way, we should acknowledge there's others in the creative group, right? So, yes, there's the rest of the creative club too. And so, talk to us about like how this relationship and friendship kind of began.
Well, we were kind of plucked, I would say. When comments were made inside our tribe community, you could see that we were all similar. And so we started to kind of piece together that we were alike. And the more the conversation started, the more that we realized we're like sisters. And so we just started talking and talking and talking, and we can't stop talking, and we were up till 1 a.m. talking. And,
every night.
It's just one of this incredible, not only friendship, but we get each other, and we can't talk to our normal friends at home the way we talk to each other. They don't get what we do.
Yeah.
And so it's really not only helped us go through the experience last year together, it's helped our businesses explode as we bounce sales pages and ideas and everything off of each other. It's just really propelled us forward.
I want to talk to some of the ways in which y'all have... I want to talk about some of the ways you guys have collaborated together and support each other. But any other comments on the friendship side of things? Because some of you actually, I know some of you hadn't even met each other in person yet, right? Till this event.
Well, Heidi, Heidi and I have actually, we're doing more collaboration together where we did a workshop. I taught the painting, and she taught our group how to do their first paint party. We've never met. Neither one of us got to go to Tribe last year. And so we just became friends online over this past year. And we were like, we really fit together. We should like try this and see what happens. And we had 375 women join our workshop. And out of that, 75 joined my membership. How many?
I think we ended up with 33 more members, bringing it to 420. So it's crazy.
Wow.
And then in addition to that, at Stu's suggestion, we were both affiliates for each other. So that made it a win-win for us. And we both sent each other a nice little bonus check before we could hit the tribe here.
And it was cool too, because our launch doesn't even happen until September 15th.
Yeah, this was just a pre-launch bonus.
Fun bonus. I was like, oh, this is nice.
So, and this is what I want to talk about, because you guys have found all kinds of ways to collaborate with each other, and it's only deepened the friendship.
Yeah.
And to that point, so Heidi and Christy came together to do a joint workshop, and I think you both reached out to me and asked a couple questions, but one of the things I said was just keep it simple.
Yes.
So talk to us about how you figured that out, because again, it's very easy to get in each other's heads or in our own heads and overcomplicate things, and then it becomes something that nobody wants to do. How did you guys keep it simple?
I think we both realized, we're both moms and wives and just busy, you know, so we wanted to do something that would benefit both our memberships, because, you know, I teach paint parties and they get one tutorial a month, but I wanted them to have her expertise on the painting side, because I always tell people, I'm like, I'm not the best artist. I'm a painter and I love it, but I'm not the best in the world. Like, you don't have to be the best painter to do what you do. And so so she's really skilled at it. And I thought, oh my gosh, that would be great. And then the same with her. You know, she doesn't want to teach really the business side, even though she rocks at that too. So we're trying to stay in our own lanes, but see how we complement each other. And then the other thing that was really cool is, because we're busy and because it was summer, we wanted to keep it short. Mm-hmm. So we made it, I mean, what, 9 days we were done?
We started on a Monday, I believe. We started on a Thursday, and then we finished the following Sunday. But so I taught day one, she taught day two, and we bounced back and forth. So it gave them a day in between teaching the painting that they could catch up if they were a little behind. They got some coaching from her. And then at the end of the 9 days, we did a final live Zoom call with them inside the group and said, well, you guys know we're launching September 15th, but because you did this workshop with us, we're going to open the doors early for you. Woo! And we were very clear and answered a lot of questions for them, like, if you want to learn how to do a paint party, I could teach you, but I don't want to. That's why I'm sending you to Heidi. And I don't want to do the business side. I love painting, and that's what brings me joy. And so we said, you know, if you want to learn the business, go with Heidi. If you own a business and you want to do more paint parties, but you want more ideas, you can get those from me, and you have the rights to my paintings to do paint parties. And a lot of those women are in both of our memberships. So we share several customers.
Yeah, I thought it was funny too, because me and Christy are both like the criers. And so on one of our Zoom calls, it's like an hour and a half long, and like she's crying at one point, I'm crying. I'm like, oh my gosh, but people just kept watching. So just kept crying and talking.
It was kind of like we had a therapy session and they just got to go along with us.
Maybe it's like the rubberneck effect, you know? Like, so the other side of this is though, because I know there's people in the audience who are logistically minded, and so they're thinking, well, wait a minute, how did you divide things, and how did you manage, like, the broadcast, and
sure.
How did you do that?
Well, I just set up a ClickFunnels page. Love ClickFunnels. Actually, that friends with them, right?
Yeah.
And then I just created it in an email system, and then we just decided to put, I mean, that's the thing. I think we, even though we hadn't met in person, we fully trusted each other.
Absolutely.
And so, you know, all the emails and the money just filtered to me, then we had a percentage go out, and then, you know, at this date, I just divided it, and then we just were off to the races. I mean,
yeah, we have Gretchen, who is part of our amazing, we call her our Facebook guru. She does
angel.
Both of our
Facebook angel.
Yes. She does our Facebook ads, and so we both agreed. I think we did $20. I don't remember what we did.
But we got $180.
Yeah, we agreed to the same amount per day, per ads that were run to each one of our pages, to our own audiences. So we kept all that separate. And then just split the money. It was a paid workshop, so it was $20 per person to join. We each got 10, you know, minus the fees.
I want you to hear the elegance in this. They split the advertising, they split the revenue made, and any emails that are being sent to promote each other's products, they're sending through their affiliate links. So if Heidi is promoting Christy, they send it through Heidi's affiliate link. So not only does Christy, when the sales are made, get the revenue because she's the owner, but Heidi also gets the affiliate commission because it's going through her link. You see the elegance in this? Very simple. Very simple.
We are not complicated. We're like simples too. I mean, there is no reason to complicate things. So we were like, I mean, we, you know, we're literally just FaceTiming each other. We're like, what makes sense? Yeah, let's just do that. That sounds good.
Well, and if two blondes can do it. I love these blondes.
We also have a group opt-in going on right
That's
now.
True.
And it's killing it. So, yeah, we have a group opt-in.
Well, so I want to hear more about this. And then I want to come to you, Tamara, because you hosted a live event. And I want to put this in perspective because it took me a while to come around to what exactly it was that you did. Because when I heard you first say decorative door hangers, I thought this was like the do not disturb signs, you know, on the hotel things, but it's not that. So explain to, probably everybody else knows, but I did. Explain what it is.
Okay, so everybody knows what a wreath is, right? You hang it on your door. This is the same thing, except it is cut out of wood. So it might be cut into the shape of, say, a snowman and painted like a snowman, and you hang it on your door.
Okay, makes sense now, right? Okay. Now, so you launched a membership helping people paint these. First, give some background on that. Like, I think people will be shocked at how many members are part of your membership.
Okay, so in 2015, I started my business, and all I was doing was painting these at home in my living room, on the dining room table, selling them, doing paint parties in my home and in other people's homes. And I did that for probably a year and a half successfully. And then this thing called Facebook Live started happening, and I'm like, well, you know, I'm bored painting by myself. I would love to paint with people. And so I turned on the camera and gave a few tips, and I have a teaching background. And so it's just naturally that flows out of me. And so I would give tips while I was painting and talking, and then people started asking more and more questions. And so about a year later, in fall of 2017, I started my first, I didn't even know what a membership site was. So I just started this thing called a virtual paint party group. And I sent them a door hanger every month, and I taught them how to paint it. But I kind of like kept capping out at about 50 members, and I realized that the audience that I had created was not people who necessarily had never painted a door hanger. It was other door hanger painters who wanted to get better at painting door hangers, and they already knew how to cut the shapes. So I'm like, okay, how can I rework this into something that's gonna work? So in April of 2018, I'm in Jennifer Allwood's group, and she starts talking about this guy named Stu and membership sites, and I'm like, well, that's kind of what I've already got going on. And so I had already planned to change it and launch something else in April, and I launched it during your workshop. Yeah. But I was planning on just leaving it open. I didn't know there was such a thing as a closed membership. And so I applied a couple of little things that you taught in your workshop, and we launched our founding launch of 400 members.
Wow. That's what I said. I said, there's 400 decorative door hanger painters? But the story continues because you did a live event.
A year later, after my membership was 1 year old, we did a live event with 150 women in Nashville, Tennessee. And Casey and Christy, who I had known for a year, and we had been Zooming on Zoom calls every month for a year together, came and they helped me with my event. She taught hand lettering and she taught some painting techniques on our door hangers, and it was just amazing.
Awesome. So let's just give these guys a round of applause. Thank you. So your membership is on hand lettering. Give people some context around what that is for those that don't know.
Yes, so we just teach you how to write pretty. And for a long time, I really didn't know that had a lot of intrinsic value. I thought, whenever I was working out my purpose, I just thought, that's what I'm doing. I'm helping people write pretty. But what I have discovered over the course of doing this is I'm really helping ladies relieve stress and anxiety and have a place of community. And I think that's been a huge, just eye-opening thing for kind of just hitting those internal problems that they have. And so every month, we take them through a boot camp where they learn the basics of how to letter, how to format your things. But then the fun happens after the boot camp, because then we do lettering projects every single month. And so we send them a little happy mail, they get some stuff to do, they watch our videos, and they create together and share. And when a lady can create something and post it on Facebook, and everybody else can be the cheerleader and say, you're awesome, this is great, that's just building more confidence. And that's what I love to see in our community.
Wow, amazing how it goes from I'm helping people write pretty to I'm helping women build confidence in themselves. You see that subtle, that massive distinction? Amazing. So you obviously, what's been your experience in terms of like, you've been helping, you went to Tamara's event, you guys are all part of this group. What am I?
Tamara.
I've had a hard time with Tamara's name. I bless my heart, thank you. And I will tell you, and my team can validate this, I was practicing your name backstage, and my team were messing with me by they were kept telling me what I have always said the wrong thing, and so my brain doesn't know which direction to go. So
two syllables.
Okay.
I really thought about wearing a sticker that said TAM-RA. That second A just throws you off.
It definitely throws me off. Got it. Tamara. I will get there. Okay. So what has this group meant to you?
Oh man, so much. We were talking last night and really reflecting over the past year, and we went back to the beginning. When I first joined Tribe, before my first launch, these ladies stepped up and said, come into my group and take every, we didn't realize it until we sat there and talked, every single one of them, before I had started, said, come into my group and teach my people. It wasn't come pitch your stuff. I was adding value to all of their memberships. I was not pitching my membership, but they were giving me their platform. And that is just incredible. In a world where so many women are catty and competition, and these ladies were just open arms saying, come on in. And so that enabled our very first launch to be 167. And
wow.
You know, and since then we've doubled it. And that wouldn't even gotten started like that without them opening their arms and saying, come on in, come to my group and let's, you know.
And I think that's a huge part of it, is because like when you're collaborating together, you gave Casey an opportunity to flesh out her material, to get comfortable with being able to teach it, present it. And there's so much power in that. And the other side of it is, how many of us in our memberships have experts, whether it be interviews or master classes, hands in the air, hands, keep them high, look at them, look around. So all of you with your hands raised can tap into the wisdom within the group. And that's exactly what you guys did.
Yeah, and I think it was, you know, just like I just tell my members, like, go to Heidi if you want to know how to throw a paint party, because I don't want to do that. I don't handle, I'm in Casey's group. I don't hand letter as well as her. So, you know, she came in my group and did that. Again, we share members. Same with Tamara and the door hanger. Like, we all are just a little bit different, but enough different that we can easily just say, go to my friend who's an expert. And they, by the way, our audience knows we're all like best friends. So, I mean, it's just kind of like we're like a group package. But it's awesome because they're getting the value from it, from an expert, instead of me just saying, I can wing it. I mean, I can show you some pretty lettering, but Casey knows what she's doing, so I'm going to have her do it.
And I love that you guys have owned that, you know. And I think that's, again, one of those where you've checked your ego at the door and said, yeah, I could possibly do that. But you know what? At the end of the day, like, the thing that I am really good at is this, and I want to encourage you to go there if you want to explore that.
Yeah.
Sarah, for you, what does this group meant for you?
You may be crying a live cast, and I'm not doing it right now. You know my journey really well, but it's like what you said to Reed. When somebody sees something in you that you can't see, every single one of these ladies here and here are members of my subscription box. And for the longest time, you know this, but I just thought it was fun and a thing to do and cute, and why wouldn't anybody want it? But what they've made me realize, and what you've helped me realize, is that it's so much more than that. It makes someone feel special. And it's women like this, it's very hard to find in our lives, especially, I mean, we're not spring chickens. You know, we're not in high school, but to have these friendships propel you to something you could never, ever, ever imagine. Sitting here, I told Christy as we were walking through that hallway bridge, I said, do you feel like we're walking taller this year? Do you feel like we have this confidence? Maybe we walked like this last year. And that's powerful, because that makes me more confident. It makes you more confident when we show up for our audiences. And that's what we've done for each other. And it's really something special.
You guys mentioned something really quickly, and I want to technology because, as you said, you have some others that are in the group. And you mentioned that Gretchen is doing your Facebook ads.
All of them.
She's changed our lives.
She's a rock star.
And I, this is another area where it's like you can help each other. And I think there's the other side of this, though, that I think is important is that there's a respect level, which is like, it's not just, it's taking advantage of somebody by saying, oh, can you just do this for me for free? Can you just do this for free? Like, there's a difference, you know what I mean, of like, hey, lending a helping hand, but having the respect of like, this is your area of expertise, like.
And it's not just a helping hand. We pay for her services.
Yes.
We pay to be members in each other's memberships. We respect that what we do is important and we should be paid for that. So it's not about that at all.
And that's my point, is that there's that respect. And I think that's one of the important parts of, you know, the developing relationships that you form. Because people can make the mistake. It's like, oh, well, hey, can you just, since you're the expert in this, can you just help do this for me for free? Do this for me for free. And when that starts to bubble up, there becomes a resentment and the relationship isn't formed. You know, and so I commend you guys, ladies, for the way in which you have supported each other and helped each other. Do you have any final thoughts, anybody, on when we're thinking about the group? You know, obviously there's Connect, but people who may or may not have joined Connect, but there's the extended tribe community. I want to encourage people to connect with each other because there is so much value and potential there. What advice would you give?
Well, I would say that you get out of it what you put into it. So if you're not in the community and you're not commenting and helping and showing up, you're not going to connect with anyone. If you're just behind your screen and you're just flipping through your phone, you're not going to connect anyone. So you show up, someone's going to see you show up and be like, I'm just like her, let's connect. And that's how it happened for us. So that's my advice.
I would just say look for how you can serve. Don't look for who can help you get ahead. Look for how you can serve other people. And like Sarah's saying, just be active in the groups that you're in. Show up there first and look how you can serve others. And I would just say, like, this didn't come together really easily in the beginning. I mean, you kind of talk with other people and you see who you fit with. So even if it's just one person that you've connected with here at Tribe Live, don't let it end when you leave here. Like, go home, and if you want to connect with them again and build that relationship a little bit further, see how it goes. And, you know, if you see that you two aren't really aligned, try with someone else. Don't give up after the first person doesn't work out. And, you know, maybe after you've got that one person and you guys find a third, you know, you can start building a little club of your own.
A little posse.
Yeah. And I think the secret to all of this, too, is that we have been vulnerable with each other. Yeah. We have cried together. We've laughed together, we celebrate together, and when somebody has a problem, we drop everything.
Yep.
And we say, what can I do for you?
Amazing.
So I think the other thing that really drew us to each other in the beginning was we were vulnerable, we were authentic, and we all have the same values too. We're all Christians, and that helped our bond together because it was something that we could relate with in dealing with business, you know. And I think last night, I mean, it was beautiful, and I said I wasn't going to cry. I'm not going to cry.
No tears.
They're yelling at me.
You always cry.
Okay. By the way, Heidi's secret, if you start to cry on stage, she says, clench your butt cheeks.
It works.
This is why we love her. She's great with advice like that.
The real behind the scenes, ladies and gentlemen.
This is how it is behind the closed doors. I won't cry though, so it's fine. But
I have noticed you're a little tighter.
But you know, last night obviously we were nervous about being up here, and the five of us went in Sarah's room, and just kidding, I'm gonna cry. And you know, we sat on a bed together, and Casey just led us in prayer and prayed over today. Prayed that we would help encourage you guys out there, that do this, like invest in the people in this community, because I literally cannot even imagine doing my business without these women. Like, not. But she prayed over us, prayed for our businesses, prayed for today, and I mean, it was just such a special moment, and we all just looked back on where we were a year and a half ago. We weren't even in each other's lives, and now we can't imagine not being in each other's lives, and it's just so special.
Amazing. I love you, Kristen.
Heidi, what are your thoughts?
I think, you know, last year I had the big FOMO, like missing out, you know, because I couldn't make it, and it just, coming here, you know, 2 days before I flew out, I just kept telling my husband, I'm like, yeah, I mean, I talk to these women every day, all day, you know, and I'm like, and I'm the one that, you know, misses like 20 chats, and then I'm like, life and stuff, 4 hours too late, and they're like, how do you grow over that? Like, move to the next one, you know, like, I'm always behind.
It was five conversations ago.
Yeah, five conversations, stop talking about. And so I was telling my husband, I was like, you know, are they going to like me? I mean, I'm just nervous. Like, I'm meeting these people. Like, I was just so, you know, like, anxious about it. And he's like, they're going to love you. It's fine. They're going to love you. And I'm like, I just want to make sure, you know. And, you know, it's almost like you're in middle school again. You're going to be welcome to the lunch table. You know, it's just this nervousness. And then we get together, and, you know, we did Niagara Falls the first day. And it was just crazy because, you know, because we've been so real online to each other, but and because they know like what we're going through inside and out, it's like it was like just immediate. I mean, it was like Will Ferrell, like, did we just become best friends? And I found my best friends at 40. I mean, I was just so excited. I was just so excited because, you know, there's not many people that you can talk to about this. Like, nobody knows this world exists. I mean, my mother-in-law, for the longest time, I love her with all my heart, but she just, still, like, my last launch was huge, and she's like, but really? Like, you're still gonna put in Facebook ads? And I'm like, yes, we're gonna sell Facebook ads now! You know, like, things like that. And so, to come to these women who know exactly, like, exactly moment for moment what's going through my head and what they're going through, like, and all of these creative people, you know, it's just, I don't know, words describe it, but not enough. It's just invaluable, and I just feel like I'll be bonded with them forever. So, yeah,
pretty amazing. Let's give these ladies a big round of applause. I think one of the reasons that I was so grateful that you all agreed to come up on the stage was to show what's possible. I can talk till I'm blue in the face about the power of this community, about us being better together. But you guys embody that, you know? And both from a business perspective, because all of your businesses have grown pretty dramatically over the last year. And there's the business side of things, but there's also the relationships and the friendship side of things. And I just think that there's many times we are forever in communities, we lose sight of the people all around us. We only see, and I'm not saying this from an ego standpoint, but you see the mouth, you know, the lips flapping. And it's like, there's only value that comes from one source. And the greatest thing that I know to be true is that I am one source, but there are so many other sources. And the collective wisdom of our tribe is hands down the most valuable thing that you can tap into. And so for me, it was just a joy to see this come together, to see you all thrive, to see the friendships and the relationships that have blossomed because of it, because I know what that makes possible. And I'm, you know, ridiculously excited for all of you. You know, I love getting your updates. I love getting the launch updates and hearing how you're collaborating together and supporting each other and teaching each other's tribes and so forth. And I just think that that is all possible for all of us if you open yourself up to it. So thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies, for opening up yourselves.
Can we have them stand really quick, please?
Yes. Let's have the other creative
colleagues. These ladies are, it's not just the five of us. There's five out here, and there's four back home that couldn't make it.
And I noticed, too, you're all wearing
Creative Club teachers. Look at you guys. All right. Just a little bit. Well, let's help me in thanking the ladies. Give them a big round of applause. You guys are amazing.